Once the filter is in this position, hand tighted, don't tighten it too much because then it's going to be hard to remove it. And then double check the cap. You can re-tighten it too, because it's very important you check this out, then this cap is tight as well. And after you have done that, the last thing to do is to reconnect the plug. And that's about it about this. Now we're gonna go back for the oil filters. The oil is completely drained on the oil filter, so now we can safely remove all of them from the housing over there. You can see that's where they are, so you can remove them all. Now it's easy, they're not tight anymore. Now all we have to do is to check and there is no seals left on the housings, there is none, so we can install the new oil filters. In this case we have three oil filters, but remember there is one that is bypass. How you gonna identify the oil filters is then the oil filters that have a small orifice and the bypass has a larger orifice. That's all you have to make sure, because in this case they don't have name. The original Volvo engine filters, oil filters, they have name, they say bypass, one says bypass. So that's how you wanna know, then you wanna install the bypass where it goes. So now we're gonna install the last one, because that is the one then we have to focus on freeze. And that's all. Yeah, see, it's the bypass, and we're gonna tighten, hand tighten. See, that should be enough. But for prevention, is always to give a little more with the tool. Just make sure to use just a bit of strength like this. That is enough. No more than this, because later it's going to be so hard to remove it. And now we're gonna be installing the other three. And there we have the three filters reinstalled, tight and secure. They're super clean, as you can see. That's the reason why you remove the plastic at the end, so that way you don't make it all dirty with your hands. So the next step is to install the drain plug. All we have to do is to place it back where we removed it, where the oil is being drained over here. And then we're gonna tighten it. You can tighten it with a small ratchet. You don't have to use a larger ratchet. And that is going to be it. Double check that. Double check that this one is tight, because that is a big problem if you don't. The last filter to replace is the fuel filter, and it's located right there. As you can see, that white part, that's the oil filter. But we need some room. We need to turn the steering wheel to this side so we can access that area. We can do it, but it's really tight. So what we're gonna do is to add the oil freeze to the engine. It's pretty easy to add the oil to this one, because in the position of how the oil filler cap is, the oil filler orifice is, I mean tube, so that's pretty easy to add it. So we're gonna be adding the oil, and then we're gonna start the engine to rotate the to turn the steering wheel to the driver's side. Right, after adding all the oil, you wanna add around 8 to 9 gallons depending. In this case, because this is the D13, if you have the D16, the D16 engine, which is the larger engine than this one, you're gonna add more oil. But the process is going to be similar for the D16 as well. It's nothing different. Probably filters are going to vary, but engine wise is similar. So everything is on place now. We have to double check oil filters. Remember that. Check the fuel water separator we already replaced, and check the drain plug. Those three things you have to check. The fuel filter we haven't replaced it yet. Don't forget it. We're gonna replace it after we start the engine, because we're gonna turn the steering wheel to driver's side. So let's start the engine. All right, engine is on. We have to check the oil pressure. Oil pressure is going up. That's all we need to make sure, and the oil pressure stays up. Now we have to check for oil leaks on the area over here. Everything is fine. Maybe running for 5 minutes.
So I'm gonna turn the steering wheel to the left because we're gonna replace the fuel filter. So now we can remove the fuel filter. So we have more room to access the area. So the fuel filter is right there, as you can see. So when I place something to collect the fuel, we're gonna drain. In the same way, when I use the tool to remove it. And remember then, if you tighten it too much, it's gonna be so hard to remove it. These things are super hard to remove when you do tighten too much. I don't know, for some reason Volvo filters just get super tight, and then it's really hard to remove them. See, this one is tight, and I remember that I hand tightened last time. All right, now it's getting looser. Loose. Then we can remove the fuel filter. It's gonna drain some fuel, so okay. That's it. Alright, we got all the fuel right here. Check the surface, and there is no seal left. It's clean. So now we are going to fill the new fuel filter with clean fuel, and now we're going to reinstall it where it goes. It's really hard to reinstall this fuel filter with one hand, so I'm gonna be using both hands. So as soon as I get it on place, I'm gonna get back to you. And the fuel filter is completely installed. You can see, completely tight. Double check it, but don't tighten it too much because this filter is super hard to remove if you tighten it with full force. Just the same way as the other filters, make sure to don't over tighten it, because later you wanna suffer, because if it's your own truck, or if you are the one that do the oil change of these trucks, you are the one that gonna pay the consequences. But if you work in a shop and you see this truck coming, please don't over tighten it, because you're gonna make some other people's job super hard. Now when I use that over here, this is a primer pump, this one over here. So all we have to do is like press it down a couple times. It is just to bleed any air that is on the system. Just a couple times, and that will be all. Alright, so the last thing to do to finish this oil change is to double check the level. You have to check the level after starting the engine. So now we just have to double check the level and make sure that it's in the correct level. Remember that it's going to be between 8 and 9 gallons of oil. It's going to be like 8 3 quarters, something like that. So just remember that. So usually by 9 gallons of oil, that's how it's going to go. And we just replace the fuel filter over here. So the last thing to do is to restart the engine. This is just to double check, then the oil, then the fuel system is working correctly. Because if for some reason you leave something bad, the engine will turn off itself, because air, that's the enemy of fuel system in diesel engines. To leave it running for a while, just to make sure that there is no problems. And that is all about the oil change process on this engine. So any questions about this, you can use the comment section below, and leave any questions, recommendations, or anything to add. Respond everybody else questions as well. You can do it. If you want to send some kind of support to my channel, you can use the description of this video. I have details on how to send support to my channel, so I can continue making helpful videos or any new videos about different trucks. Stay tuned, there is different videos coming in the future. So yeah, I still wanna be doing videos like this, but there are new videos as well that are different than I'm pretty sure you already saw on my channel. So that's all. Make sure to like the video, share it, subscribe, very important, and thank you for watching.